Hey guys, I'm Surbhi and once again welcome to my channel Key Differences. Today in this video lesson, we are going to discuss the barriers to effective communication. So friends, let's get started. Communication barrier. Communication barrier implies any form of hindrance occurring at the time of communication due to any reason which disturbs the flow of communication. That is, when one party is not able to understand or get the message conveyed by another party accurately, clearly and intendedly, then that barrier is called as communication barrier. The barrier to effective communication often led to distortion of the message, which not only wastes the time, money and efforts of the parties to communication, but also causes confusion and misunderstanding. There are a number of barriers to communication which may occur at any stage of the process, and these barriers often interrupt the entire flow of communication and result in the failure of interpersonal communication. These barriers are physical barriers, semantic barriers, organizational barriers, personal barriers, psychological barriers, cultural barriers, attitude barriers, technology barriers, physiological barriers and gender barriers. Now here I am going to explain you each one of them in detail. The first one is physical barriers. Physical barriers are a result of our surroundings, that is our physical environment. It arises due to weather or climate, time and distance between the sender and receiver of the message, disturbance in the medium of communication, workspace design, noise, etc. The next one is semantic barriers. Also called as linguistic barriers, these barriers often develops misunderstanding between the sender and receiver due to various meaning of words and symbols used in the process of communication. It occurs when the sender or recipient have a very limited language proficiency or do not have a good knowledge about the use of words. It takes place due to bad or unfamiliar expressions during the process of communication, using technical terminology, unclarified assumptions, faulty translations, denotations and connotations, use of words having multiple meanings, etc. Organizational barriers. Organizational barriers refers to the disruption in the process of communication among the members of the organization, that is managers, supervisors, employees, directors, etc. This type of barrier occurs due to inappropriate information transmission system, lack of supervision, unclear organizational hierarchy, undefined roles and responsibilities, organizational rules and policies, complex organizational structure, etc. Personal barriers. Personal barriers are the factors personal to the sender or recipient of the message, like life experiences, emotions, behavior, attitude, etc., that stops a person from communicating rationally. These barriers arise out of lack of listening skills, selective attention or perception, lack of knowledge, lack of vocabulary, and unwillingness of the sender or recipient to communicate. Psychological barriers. Psychological barriers, as the name suggests, are the barriers related to the psychological state of a person. That is attitude, point of view, perception, emotion, opinion, status consciousness, and so forth. It is also known as emotional barriers. It is caused by lack of attention, premature assumption, poor retention power, distrust between the communicators, defensiveness, suspicion of intention, jealousy and anxiety. Next is cultural barriers. You might have noticed that when a person possesses knowledge of different cultures, he or she can communicate effectively and better than others with the people belonging to another culture. Due to the difference in culture of parties to communication, words and symbols may be understood in a different way as intended, which causes miscommunication. Attitude barriers. Attitude of a person also affects the process of communication. You might have noticed that an energetic, and motivated employee will always be ready for communicating effectively to his seniors and subordinates, whereas a lethargic and dissatisfied employee may not even try to initiate the process and even refuse to communicate, which causes misunderstanding and confusion. Technology barriers. Technology has helped the people to communicate faster and better than before, both within the organization and outside the organization. Technology barrier is specifically related to the medium of communication, which should be latest and advanced for an effective communication flow. However, both the parties should be using the same technology to communicate effectively, or else the communication would be difficult. It is caused by use of outdated or old software or technology, accessibility barrier, mode of communication, that is online or offline, etc. Physiological barriers. As the name suggests, these barriers arise out of physical state of the sender or receiver, which includes physical inability of the party to communication to sense the message communicated by another party. The disability include poor vision, ill health, hearing disability, speech disorder, poor memory, etc. Lastly, gender barriers. There is a huge difference in the way men and women communicate. That is, men usually talk in a logical and straightforward way, whereas women use both logic as well as their emotions when they talk. Further, women are more talkative in comparison to men, and this often creates a disparity in the way they communicate and often causes misunderstanding during the process of communication. Overcoming barriers to effective communication. There are certain ways which can help in overcoming the barriers to communication, and thus it prevents confusion and misunderstanding to take place between the sender and recipient of the message. Now come, let's discuss those ways. Employee orientation. The new joinees should be informed about the company's plans, policies, procedures and authority relations during the process of orientation, and in this way conflicts and misunderstanding can be avoided to a great extent. Developing good interpersonal relations. Good interpersonal relationships should be developed and maintained in the organization, which helps in accomplishing goals. For this purpose, status differences should be shelved, suggestions and valid criticism should be appreciated. Active listening. Active listening is a key to effective communication. It implies paying full attention and showing interest to what is being said, and giving the speaker proper time and opportunity to state his viewpoint and not prematurely assuming anything. Use of proper language and dialect. Semantic barriers can be avoided by communicating in such a language which is straightforward, simple to understand and meaningful as well. The sender should avoid the use of technical jargons and also talk in a dialect which is familiar to the receiver. Use of proper body language and gesture. You might have heard the saying that actions and deeds speak louder and clearer than words, and so proper body language and gestures are to be used while communicating the message, otherwise it may lead to communication failure. Use of latest technology. To minimize the disruptions during the communication process, one should use latest technology, which not only makes communication better but faster also. Feedback. Feedback is the most important part of every communication process. Communication is said to be meaningful and effective when the feedback is received at the end of the process and as it was expected. So friends, this brings me to the end of this lesson. Thanks a lot for watching this video. If you find this lesson useful, please like this video, share it with your friends, and if you have any queries or feedback for me, you can comment below. And guys, do subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from Key Differences. I'll be back soon with a new lesson. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.